play with it. It's dangerous. Okay, are you ready?
Mummy and I met many, many years ago in a place called Delphi House. She was a nurse, I was a doctor. At night, we'd tell each other stories.
She'd tell me about the future. Wonderful things. Things only she could see.
I'd tell her about the past.
About a great priestess, marked with a butterfly,
who could stare into the fire and see the future.
I used to tell her she was magic.
Just like the priestess.
I think you're magic too.
But you're gonna have to prove it.
Pick a photograph. Pick your favorite. Now, close your eyes. Focus your mind.
And conjure the power of the ancient priestess.
Now find your mom again. See if you can guess where your favorite is.
See? Magic. She'll always be with you. Remember that.
Even though she isn't here, she's still a part of you. If you could stare into the fire and see the future, what do you think you'd see?
Thank you. Miss Mason, I'm Sergeant Blake, the lead investigator on this case. Can I see that? I promise I'll give it back. You draw this a lot. It's Greek, isn't it? The Delphic Epsilon.
It was on the medallion, too.
The hand belonged to a Kal Jahar. He worked at Delphi House. I believe you visited there with your father.
This is about my father.
Your father's case was never solved. I'm pretty sure there's a connection. Did you know he co-founded Delphi House with this man, Lucian Flowers? We think Mr. Flowers might be a target too. Look, we're keeping watch over at Delphi House. Protection detail. I'll be leading the investigation from there. Right now, it's the safest place for you too. They're probably out for a smoke. Wait here, I'll go check.
What are you doing? Put that down. It's not yours. There's no note. No record of her anywhere. Right.
Well, that was a waste of time. I see you found someone. I guess I should have just stayed put.
I saw some girls. They were wearing masks.
Yeah. I'll check it out. I think it's some kind of therapy.
Who are you?
I'm Sergeant Blake. I'm leading the investigation. I'm supposed to meet a Dr. Ballard.
I can only apologize. We're all a bit nervous here. Sergeant Blake, I'm Rosa Ballard. I suppose you already know Chief Inspector.
Sir, this is Erica Mason.
I'm sorry we're meeting in such difficult circumstances. Is there anything we can do to make you feel at home?
It's okay. I'm sorry too.
Come on. I'll show you the way. I suppose you don't remember me. I worked with your father.
I used to look after you when you were little.
You knew my parents?
Of course. Your dad taught me everything I know. And your mum, she was incredible. Brilliant nurse, so smart, so funny. Anyway, this is you. You might recognize it.
Mr. Steinbeck, the night manager, will be downstairs if you need anything.
Look under the bed. Uncle Lucy got you something. It should keep you out of trouble.
Look at her arm. She's just like you.
Kirsty, I said you can help, but I need to be with you, okay? We talked about this. No cleaning without supervision.
Talk about it.
Come on, Toby. I'm trying to play. Leave the girl alone.
Whatever.
Your death wish. Over here. Don't mind her. She's got emotional problems.
Hurry up and die, Hannah.
I'm doing my best.
She seems nice.
Yeah. But it's not her fault. I blame society. Here, take a seat. Let me show you something. Do you see this bit? It's simple. Four notes. Bum, bum. Bum. I'll do the rest.
She likes to be the center of attention. She's all wide-eyed innocence until she doesn't get her own way, and then it's...
Stop that!
Erica, Sergeant Blake's here. Needed in the main office.
Come in. My God. Erica Mason. You look just like your mother. Last time we met, you could barely see over the desk. I'm Lucien Flowers. I set this place up with your father.
I thought I was meeting Sergeant Blake.
He just stepped out to make a quick call. Did you sleep okay? I know the old place can take a bit of getting used to.
The man on the desk.
Mr. Steinbeck, yes. I believe he was rather rude. I can only apologize. I'll be speaking to him personally. I know it's very difficult for you to be here. And it's not much, but I brought you something. It was your father's. Your mother gave it to him on their wedding day. I just kept hold of it.
Hey. Sorry about that. I was just getting an update from forensics.
Erica, it's extremely likely whoever killed your father killed Mr. Johar. There may be some other victims as well we don't know about. It's likely they'll try and kill again.
Are you sure?
There's no public appeal. Nothing in the press. The chances of this being a copycat are extremely low. Honestly, we don't have much to go on.
But Mr. Flowers has a suggestion. It might help you remember the face of your father's killer.
I was just a little girl.
Right. You're older now, stronger.
It's like therapy. It was developed by your father. It's completely painless. Perfectly safe.
I don't know.
Erica, please. There are too many similarities with your father's case for it to be a coincidence.
If we can get a description, we can put an end to this.
I'm sorry, I can't.
It's okay, Erica. We understand. Your mother told me this place was her whole life. She worked here, fell in love here, had you here. Later, she died here.
I'm so sorry, Erica. I should have been there for you. I should have done more.
It's okay. It was a long time ago.
Come on. I want to show you something.
We'll need these. Your father had the oleander planted in your mother's memory. They were her favorite. They've always brought us luck.
Get off me! Leave me alone! Get off me!
Sorry. Sometimes the girls have difficult days.
But some of us like to keep it buried deep down inside.
Hannah, I didn't think you'd be up. This is Erica Mason. She'll be staying with us for a while.
I saved her from Toby by heroically bleeding all over the piano.
I'm taking these to Doc Ballard. We're making perfume. Do you want to come?
Fuck off! What is wrong with you?
Well, you could always go hang out with Toby.
Actually, they're about to serve lunch. It's quite a spread. Why don't you go and grab yourself a bite and maybe meet some of the other girls?
Sure. Who doesn't love a good old soggy sandwich in the company of strangers?
Okay, perfume sounds good.
They used oleander at Delphi in ancient Greece, where they thought it gave the power of second sight. It was set on fire, the fumes inhaled. The priestess saw visions of the future.
That's a bit of a shame. They could have just soaked it and made one hell of a perfume.
I'd rather see the future than smell good.
Erica, can you get the matches out of the desk, please? Top left drawer.
Sure.
Curiosity, Erica, seldom goes unpunished.
Sorry, I didn't mean to.
It's okay. I'm a bit nosy myself. Come on. Honor is yours. Now all we have to do is wait. Luckily for you girls, here's one I made earlier. Put that by your bed.
And I promise you the sweetest of dreams.